IVM.
For all you nerds out there who love to read comic books, watch superhero movies and debate about that, we have a cool podcast suggestion for you. Check out Geek Fruit, which comes out every Monday on the IVM podcast app, website, or wherever you listen to podcasts. Hello everybody, you're listening to Keeping It Queer with me, Navin Noronha,
and Farhad.
Hi guys, welcome to Keeping It Queer. A whole new week, a whole new show, and a whole new guest on our podcast this time. But before that, I have my co-host Farhad.
Hi.
What's up, Farhad? How's it been?
It's been. fuck, that's it. That's the update.
It's been. How do you like go day to day, man, like that sometimes?
That's how I go day to day. Just knowing that it's day to day living.
What do you do?
Oh my god.
Wow, and I guess
straight
up, taking
straight
over.
Up, where's my seatbelt? What do I do? I'm a chef. I'm a part-time chef.
Where?
Head chef at a German restaurant here in Bandra.
Called?
Malzite, Berlin Street Food. And I freelance as a social media. I hate saying that one, so I'm not even going to complete that. But yeah, you got it. That one.
Oh, nice.
So yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much.
You're the guest now, Farhad. Surprise.
Hi.
But our guest today is one of my dearest friend, my bestest friend in the world. And someone I can tell everything at any time, Jeeya Sethi, is in the house. Hi, Jeeya.
Hi.
If we ever not become friends in future, this episode will be very awkward, okay? So don't fight with me, I'm telling you. It's gone on the internet and it's forever out there.
I don't think I'll ever fight with you.
Why?
Because there's nothing to fight about. You're so lovable.
Thanks. I was just fishing for compliments up top. But today we're discussing fag hags.
I have no friends.
That's why I got mine for the show. I asked Farhad if you have any guests. Like, I have no friends. I'm like, let me get my friends. But a fag hag is someone, it's a common term used across the gay community. When a gay person has a best friend in the form of a woman who they can confide in, tell them everything, have sleepovers, but not sleep with each other. At any point, you know, that kind of equation.
Does it need to be explained? I think people know what a fag
is. It a beard?
I mean, a beard is someone you date. Like, you just show that you're dating them to, you know, defray the fact that you're gay.
I was your beard for a while, right?
No, you were not.
Yeah.
This is the first time I'm hearing. What beard?
Like, you know, when you're in high school and you're gay, but you still want to, like, have respect of your people. So you date a girl to show that you're also, like, one of the boys.
Oh, wow, did that.
So that girl is a beard.
Oh, basically. That's a beard.
Yeah.
Like a beard.
Like a beard, yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. I'm old, so I know that term. I don't know fag hag. I think
this is the
new
first time I'm hearing of it, but okay.
Yeah, so fag hag is a new age term, which is...
For beard.
For beard. But not exactly, because like in the eyes of the world, we're not dating or anything. We're just like, we're really cool friends.
I mean, the wellness guy thinks you're my boyfriend.
Tell us the wellness story, come on.
I went to wellness to get some medicines and the wellness guy is like, so, bhaiya kaise hai? And I'm like, kaun sa bhaiya? I have no bhaiya in my life. He's like, wo mera bhaiya nahi hai, uske paas khud ka bhaiya hai.
Basically, because we like, after every show, we'd go to wellness, you know, buy something, and then I'd spend nights at her place. Oof. And just like, so my mom also was like, after I came out, also was rest assured for a while that I was like having sleepovers with a girl. So something's probably right with me. Like, you know, eventually I'm experimenting with a girl to see if it goes somewhere. I even told her, Jeeya's 10 years older than me. She was like, it's okay, like, as long as. Yeah, but then like I've used Jeeya for multiple different reasons in my life.
We spent Valentine's Day together.
Yeah, 1 year.
And last year.
Yeah.
And we went for
a drag show.
Mm-hmm.
That was okay. Quite an experience.
Yeah.
Wow. I feel like anything I say today will be an interruption.
No, go on.
No, I don't know. I have no fag hags. I have hags, but I don't know if they're fag hags. So.
How so?
They're just around, but I don't think they like me because I'm gay. Or that's what's projected.
They like,
right?
You generally.
They like me generally, but I've always had this idea of fag hags as being like overtly wanting to be your friend just because you're gay.
No,
at least that's how it's shown.
No, so that's
right?
That's like a bad example of a fag
okay,
hag. You know,
okay.
Like we have different versions.
Okay.
The one you confide in the most, the
villain
one,
Grace.
Yeah,
Grace fag
the
hag.
Grace is a fag okay, hag. So okay, it's like, you know, it makes okay. sense when you like, if you go to like even see. In Modern Family, Mitch has a sister who, even though they have like a bad equation, he can still tell him everything about, tell her everything about his family life and his relationship advices or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
So like, and I think, I don't even know how I was drawn to Jeeya, because it was just like, we were, We were friends from before. The camera's capturing everything. We were friends from the comedy circuit, of course. Okay. But like the common will to like gossip and bitch about people is what really brings us together.
Oh my God. Yeah. He's such a good bitch, right? Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. He's the best. And when he gets nasty, he really gets nasty.
Has he ever brought me up in conversation not to feel important? Okay, she has no idea who I was before she met me. Okay, hi Jeeya.
Hi.
No, it's mostly people we commonly know.
Oh,
like, so
you
it's
don't
like,
bitch about me ever, Navin. Well, I don't give you fodder to bitch about ever.
There's nothing to bitch about.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Have you all ever hooked up?
Never.
Oh,
never.
No.
Yeah.
When's that happening?
Never. Oh, my God.
Both of you are sitting like this.
I'll have a sip of water.
I'll sip my green tea.
Mm.
Oh, that sounds going.
Was the thesis.
Mm.
But I remember once I had called Jeeya over for Christmas this time. Not because like I want to call Jeeya alone, but I want to call my boyfriend also. So okay. So
the fag hag comes in.
The fag hag comes in and she is like a buffering before, like if in case my mom like loses her shit, at least there's one more woman who can take care of it. And
but they were damn sweet. They were damn nice.
But made me awkward a lot because like my friends are there and my mom's like, yeah, he never told us earlier what he is, and all of that is happening. Remember?
Yes.
And then my mom's like, I was so shocked. And it's like my mom is like, okay, there's a film crew and I'm doing confessional hour right now and telling everything to my friends.
Mm.
But it was cute. I think like that's what's also an important role of a fag hag, I think.
Yeah.
But you said you know bad fag hags.
Like. I don't know bad fag hags. I just know that there have been very obvious moments where a girl tried extra hard to be my fag hag. And that kind of irritates me. Like, there are certain indicators I feel like where someone's trying too hard to be a fag hag.
Yeah.
Number one, tell me everything about your life, which I don't want to.
Yeah, yeah.
Secondly, you're gay, my friend's gay, I should set you up. That's a big one. And those are the ones I'm usually wary of. But if I had to like tell you, oh, my one fag hag, I genuinely am like at a loss for like, what do I say?
Are you closer to boys?
I'm way closer to boys.
Cool.
Yeah.
So maybe that's why you don't have a fag hag.
Yeah. And sometimes even more than, in fact, most of my even like best friends are not gay. Like all of them are straight boys. So I don't know what, I guess that's how far I am on this fag hag chart, like, you know. So, yeah.
Do you have sisters?
I don't.
That's probably why as well, because he has two sisters.
Yeah.
And so he obviously gets along.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I have girls. I just don't consider... No, how do I say this? I just don't consider them fag hags, but if anyone else saw us, they'd be like, okay, this is his fag hag, but I don't see it like that at all. Maybe it's a me problem. It's a me problem.
It's not a problem.
It's okay, man.
Yeah,
but now looking at you both like jostling around, I'm like, oh, I wish I had a fag hag.
You can have Jeeya. Like,
I want to go to wellness forever to buy things.
Yeah, but then like, I think it's good to like also have someone to like buffer in life in general. Like as I was saying, the Christmas time also. But otherwise also in life, like if I have no clue where to go, I go to Jeeya's. I think like a lot of us in the comedy circuit have done that a lot now. So do you think that that's a thing that comes with age?
Yeah. Also, I'm a nice human being. Fuck off.
Sure.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah, you are nice. Yeah. But like you are selectively nice. Like, you know, and... Like, there are times when I don't know what to tell Jeeya because I'll go to her house and chill and she's like, give me gossip because I'm like, I don't know, I have nothing. Then, like, I'll have to sometimes make something up.
Have you ever made something up? I don't think so.
No, I have not made something up. I always know something or the other and she knows always something or the
so
other.
So, what do you do? Like, are you all from the same circle? What's this
The
gossip?
Comedy circuit.
Okay, like, okay. So, that's where all the gossip is.
Yeah, like, so we're both comics and producers.
Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah.
So, we bitch about comics and producers.
Yeah. But as you were speaking about like the bad fag hacks, the ones who like try to embed yourself, there's one comic. Yeah.
I want tea.
And from the day like she's found out, she's like, dude, I'm going to become an officiator when you get married. I'm going to marry you and your boyfriend no matter what happens.
God.
And that was like the first time I was in a relationship. And then like I forgot about it. Then I got into a new relationship. Again, like she was at a venue and she started doing the same thing. In fact, like barraging my boyfriend also with like unnecessary.
Why do you think they do that? Why do they want to be your friend? Like, what's that about? I've tried to scrutinize this. And while we are talking about this, I think another reason maybe because I'm more bi, so there's always a tendency for like for it not to be a fag hag and fag kind of equation, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
there's always a possibility that it might become a, hey, are these feelings? Are you catching feelings? You're so cute, Farhad. And I sometimes fall for chicks. And actually, fuck. Now I'm suddenly sad. I think that's what happened to my last fag hag.
Yeah, I should have.
Like, I kind of liked her.
Yeah.
Shit.
And then, would you?
I told her, but she was like, I thought you were a fag. So that's pretty much where it left. Yeah, where I left it. Because I gave her the details, right? She knew everything that's going on in my life. So I feel like, I'm in like a weird limbo. When it comes to this whole fag hag conversation, I'll just be like, yeah.
Maybe that's how you get rid of fag hags. You tell them you like them.
But they won't believe. Who will believe it? My fag hag did not believe me. She's like, but I thought you sucked it.
Yeah, we're all out there. And like, what happened?
Don't you get fucked in the butt?
Like, how do you come back from there then? Like,
begging.
Then I think it should be like, you should maintain up top that, hey, I'm also into girls. Like, you know?
Yeah.
Then that's true one way of it. But I've never been into girls, so I don't know.
Okay.
And I mean, like, Jeeya and I have also tried drag together. Like, she used to also be in theater, so she has like an entire box of wigs and clothes.
Okay.
I dressed him up.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
He looked like a gorgeous woman.
I think I've seen this picture.
Yeah, I showed it to you.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
he has a daddy, so that's weird.
No, ajkal kya hai? Who's the popular, what's her name? With the beard.
The skinny one, no?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I don't like it.
I love it. It's
you
like
know
a
who
new
we're talking
thing
about, right?
I have no idea.
Are that skinny?
She's like an international Miss something.
Oh, no. I think we're talking about different people. I'm talking about that guy we saw.
Conchita Wurst. Is that her name?
You're the only one who knows this.
Okay. I think her name is Conchita
Wurst. But I've seen
Wurst.
A lot of bearded drag queens.
Yeah, she's like a beautiful woman, but she has a proper Middle Eastern, nicely clipped beard.
Correct.
And she looks stunning.
So, like, different forms of drag are evolving. So, I'm like, fat bearded queens also here to stay. But, Jeeya, tell me, like, from where does the, you know, association with queerness begin in your life? Because when I spoke to you, you were, like, really chill. Like, you were all like, oh, there's nothing big about it. But, like, we can talk about boys and all of that. But, like, from your perspective, when was the first time that you were introduced something queer in your life?
You know, when I was, like, 19, I was in England.
Okay.
And I was at a gay bar. And I was scandalized, for sure. Culture shock. There were these two big buff guys just all over each other. And I'm just like messaging my friend in India, oh my God, this is so weird. Yeah. And then right in front of me, there were these two gorgeous women also all over each other. I'm like, that's so beautiful. That is so pretty. It just, I don't know, it's that seemed natural. But this I was thoda sa like, oh my God, I've never seen it right.
How long have you guys been friends?
3 years plus.
Yeah, 3+ years now.
Okay.
So we also were in the same improv group at one point.
Okay.
So that's why. And then like, when I was in a relationship with the Dubai chef.
What? How come I don't, wow.
You know this.
This is his main relationship.
Wow. I know Dubai. I know you even went, right?
To
Dubai.
Yeah.
I was wow at the chef thing. I don't think you told me he's a chef. I just thought you told me he was a guy from Dubai.
Yeah, I give you very limited information, I realize now in my life.
Okay.
I think I'm saving it out for the podcast, so you have these reactions when I do it.
Sure.
But yeah, so like I dated him for like 9 months and then...
He's into chefs, just saying.
Feed me good. Feed me nice.
Yeah.
But like Jeeya was immediately drawn to him. Like she also like liked him. So in a way, I was looking for her approval in a way. Like, you know.
Okay.
So even when I met him, I remember like we'd gone for a show together. Mm. And...
He was really cute.
Yeah. He is really cute. But...
he's not going to listen to this, okay?
I don't
How do you
give
know?
A shit.
You never know. Baskin Robbins heard our podcast. Okay, don't.
What is Baskin Robbins?
Long
I need
story,
to know.
Long story.
It's not important anymore.
Yeah.
Anyway,
season 2, okay. But what was I saying? So then basically like... What happened on the first day we were chilling properly was like he was on the ground floor and I was on the first floor. We were separated because of a weird faux pas.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like entirely stranded away from him and I was just like yearning to see him. and sit next to him, but like our friend was sitting next to him. And then when I came down, like Jeeya helped me up because she was being a bitch. And I kept looking at him, like, and then she's like, look at you, you can't stop looking only. All that stuff was happening.
Do that again.
This is how you sound in his head.
Yeah, I know.
Look at you.
But I also was very wary of his feelings for him because he was very attached and very much in love with that guy.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. As in you're being protective.
Fully protective. Okay. Oh my God. I would give him so much grief about it. But he's grown a lot as a human being since then. He's aware of how to control his emotions.
Hmm. Yeah. So I think back then, like, I fully, like, fell for it.
No? Yeah, fully. Like, without any fucking barriers. Yeah, nothing. He just was, like, all in. I was like, I love you. Oh, my God. He went to Dubai.
Oh. Nobody goes to Dubai for a man.
I wasn't going to settle down in Dubai. That was why, like, because the idea was like he was trying to convince me to move there, and I was like, come back to Mumbai. He's like, no, I'm like, let's move to Bangalore together, you know. Okay. Then it's like, let's go to Canada. I'm like, no money. So like all of that shit happened.
Shit, that was serious.
Huh? Yeah, it was a proper serious relationship.
And this is 9 months, you said?
Yeah, it lasted 9 months.
Okay.
But like, you know, sometimes you have like a whirlwind romance.
I know. It's inception time. Like in 9 months you had, and I always double, like gay relationships. If it's 9 months, I feel a gay relationship wise, you had a 2 year relationship.
And that's what
dog
like,
years old.
Yeah,
but
my God.
During that time, she was protective, but also a little insecure because she felt like she was losing me at some point.
You know, I was actually going to ask you a question a while ago. Tell me how this works. If you suddenly found out that she's good friends with another gay guy, would that affect you?
No.
Like she was fag hagging with him.
Like I know she's friends with another gay guy, but like I know I'm the only fag in her life.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know how that makes sense, but
I think I'm just a jealous human being in life.
Okay.
In general.
No, I wanted to know if Navin would get affected. Like if you're fag hag, is she exclusive to you as a fag hag is what my question is.
I think you are.
Do you have another woman in your life?
No.
What about Dang?
Like she was a fag hag, and then like we moved cities, so we were not that close as such.
Ashika, but Dang, you're still my fag hag. Yeah.
Oh, see, you found a fag.
Actually, it's not like a found. You know, the thing is, me and Harshika grew up together. Like literally, by grew up, I mean she used to live diagonally opposite to my house. I'm so happy she's gonna, if she hears this.
Yeah.
And I've never told her this, but like I literally saw Harshika Dang grow up in front of me, and like, now we are all grown up, and somehow I feel, oh shit, now I feel like the rest of my friends shouldn't hear this in Pune, but I feel like a lot of them are still stuck, you know, in that old school Pune, like, And I feel like me and Harshika have evolved a lot. So we have a tendency, like whenever we are in at the same shadi or the same this, we tend to be like above the this, you know, like we got the gossip, we are cooler, we got that vibe going. So in that sense, in some fraction of a way, Harshika Dang, you're my fag hag.
And Harshika introduced me to you as well, by the way. The first time we met was because of Harshika. We were at NH7. Yeah. And it's a very funny story, okay?
Yeah.
So we are at NH7 and we are roaming the food hall where like the food is there.
Yeah.
And Harshika, you and Harshika.
Like, yeah. And Harshika is like, Farhad, I see you. And she ran towards Farhad and I followed her. And Kamra was with us, okay? And Kamra was just like loitering around us. And back then he was not the Kunal Kamra. He was a chubby, berry Kunal Kamra of the good old days.
You wanted to.
Yeah. But then like I started talking to Farhad and we were like, and Harshika is like no qualms or no barriers. She's like, he's also gay, you also gay, talk to each other, like that kind of person. So then he was like, Farhad was like, and then you had a beard back then, I remember you had this weird,
I had quite a weird beard going.
I like this look more, I'm just like being
thank
honest
you, thank
but
you.
But then Farhad was like, so gay, huh, like what do you like? And I'm like,
Navin, let me stop you right there. I think you got nobody's voice in your head, right? I don't think I said it like
so
that.
I
don't remember.
It's my impersonation of
everything. If you talk like this, so again.
I don't remember doing that at all.
Okay, then how are you doing it?
In fact, my only memory is like catching up with Harshika and constantly looking at you at the side. I think you're eating one of those giant wafers on sticks kind of thing.
No, I was eating a bratwurst.
Okay.
German hot dog. From Malzide only, by the way.
Oh.
From the Pune one.
Okay, I used to not work there then.
Yeah.
But
were you attracted to him the first time you saw him?
I knew that he had the look. Mm-hmm. I knew he had the look, which is a look we all know. Yeah? You know what I'm talking about?
No.
It's the look.
What's the look? Show us the look.
I can't do it.
Come on.
No, it's a look. It, you know, oh, you're gay, I'm gay. You know, look.
that way too, yeah. You do check them out top to bottom. Types.
Yeah, no. I'm not saying it was a checker. It was just a, you know, our faggy senses antennas, tingling. Yeah, like, yeah. You know, there's one in the room close by.
But that's what, like, so Farhad asked me, like, what kind of men do you like? And I immediately pointed at Kamra instead of saying the kind of men I like. And Kamra got so awkward, he walked away from
Shut
that.
Shut up, yeah. I have no memory of this. And yeah. In fact, I know Kunal Kamra very recently because yeah. I started following
this. This happened like in a very small, like, matter of 2-3 seconds. And that's why it was all lost in my memory because I was just like, how do I even, like, explain the kind of men I like? I'm just like, gonna be like, this guy is a prototype of the kind of men I like.
Okay, then and I thought maybe he's not into me.
Yeah, and I've made Kunal Kamra very awkward a lot of times in the past. Like, you know, openly admit to this, like, sometimes they say that straight boys get really, like, whatever.
Mm.
But I just feel like sometimes someone has to bat for the chubby boys. So, like, you know, throughout their life, nobody's looked at them the way, like, some chubby admirers like me look at them.
Aww.
So you know, no, I feel that. I always look at you like that. Like,
thanks.
You are the one who, like, makes us feel nice, you know?
Thanks, man.
That we are wanted and we are craved and,
You're yeah. not chubby, shut up. It's like...
He's...
Dude, I don't think we can be Fag Hag.
Alright,
we
should take a break at this point and we'll come back in part 2. We'll continue with this awkwardness that I've created.
Sure.
Then I'll tell you all about how Navin wanted to sleep with me.
Ugh.
Done.
Oh, okay.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please make sure you do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. On our social media, one of the things we do is if you send us a screenshot of what you're listening to, we will repost it on our social network so that people can see that what people are listening to. Put us some comments and we'll respond to them. Also want to let people know that we're still hiring. We're looking for producers, content creators, audio engineers, developers, designers, and business roles, and basically all kinds of other things. Go to the careers page on ivmpodcast.com or send us an email at careers@indusvox.com. Wanted to announce two new shows that we are starting, Tech Careers in the New and Agla Station Adulthood. Tech Careers in the New is a brand new podcast presented by Accenture. It's hosted by our very own Shiladitya Mukhopadhyay, my co-host on Shunya One. On this show, he's talking to Accenture leaders about the latest and greatest in the world of technology and gives exclusive tips on technology careers, how to grab opportunities and stay relevant. Watch out for fortnightly episodes on Wednesdays starting July 3rd. The other new show that we're launching this week is an exciting show called Agla Station Adulthood, where best friends Ritasha Rathore and Ayushi Amin ride through the various stations of life. Whether you're in your mid-20s, just entering them, or about to cross into the next decade, tune into this fun show. On the Seen and the Unseen, author and researcher Manu Pillai returns, this time to have an in-depth conversation about his new book, The Courtesan, the Mahatma, and the Italian Brahmin. They discuss an extremely wide range of topics from Italian sages to Gandhian principles to what India would have looked like without the British invasion. On Keeping It Queer, Navin and Farhad are joined by our producer at IVM and stand-up comedian Abbas Momin to discuss straight pride. Continuing our producer special on paperback, we have our producer Madhuri Advani talking about storytelling and her intervention into various spaces through stories. On the Edges and Sledges cricket podcast, DJ and Varun discuss the match between India and Afghanistan and delve into a deeper conversation with Michelle St. Patrick Hewitt from West Indies and James Butler, host of the Cricket Badger radio show podcast. On States of Anarchy, writer and columnist Devika Kher joins Hamsini to talk about the lack of jobs the world over, the gender disparity at workplaces, and the possible solutions to them. On the Pragati podcast, environmental researcher Lingaraj Jayaprakash joins Pawan to talk about climate change, air pollution, and the looming water crisis. On The Origin of Things, Chuck narrates the story of hills, college memories, and deadly encounters. Will you be able to guess the brand before Chuck reveals it? And with that, let's continue with your show.
Welcome back to Keeping It Queer, everybody. Jeeya Sethi is here. Hi, Jeeya.
Hi.
Wow, you'll synchronize that.
Mm.
So Farhad is also here, but you already said your highs, yeah.
Yeah.
And so Jeeya, like, you said that first time you ever saw somebody was at a bar.
Yes.
And then, like, did it change? The perspective for you was like, oh, two men, like, suddenly it was too jarring for you. And to this day, you're a little too, like...
No, PDA in general, yeah. I'm not okay with. In general, I'm not okay with PDA. It doesn't matter if you're two boys or girl, boy, girl, girl, whatever. It's just not that orthodox thinking or...
No, I don't think it's orthodox. I get fucking uncomfortable. And I've been to orgies and I get fucking uncomfortable with PDA a little, like... Yeah.
Yeah, so that's my
only thing. Wow, you're boldly against love.
That's not against love.
How is that against love?
Do it behind doors, no?
No, okay. I'm not there. I'm not there, but like, yeah, I'm just... I don't want to see two other people.
So yeah, so imagine that, right? PDA in general, I don't like. Now imagine social media PDA.
Okay.
Right,
okay.
That's too much.
Wait,
right?
This is social media PDA.
No. I'm generally giving information about how.
Yeah. You know, can I tell you something freaky? It's not PDA, but I've recently been following an Instagram page. It's run by two gay boys who are a couple.
Mm.
And they've made a profile for their imaginary child.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
And it's very creepy. It's very creepy because they put up pictures like, you know, those online simulators, like you take one picture and one picture and then this is what you pay. So they just keep generating new pictures using that. They just keep changing the clothes and all. And then they put up pictures as this baby, like this baby has its imaginary baby has its own. And then they respond to that baby as themselves.
Like, how do you know it's imaginary?
Because that fucking child looks creepy. digital.
Oh.
It's not a real child. And their bio says something like, for our...
Do you guys want to have babies?
In general?
Yeah, like, do you want to have your own child?
You know, there are two reasons I want to have a child. One is just to test, like, if I'm a good father. And second is just to project all my shit on, like, damage him. So both are not good reasons.
Has to be a boy or what?
No. I just feel boy because I have this, I don't know, I know it's stupid, but I always had this, this boy will exactly, if he has the same journey as mine, like, oh, he realizes at 12 or 13 or whenever, like, he's into dick, then how will I have handled that situation? Maybe that's why I said him, but I'd be more than happy to have a girl. Yeah.
Yeah.
You want a baby?
I used to wanted to have a baby. But I don't know. I'm like, now I can get a dog and I'll be happy with that.
Yeah, I got a cat.
Like, I had an imaginary child myself. And
what was the child's name?
Arya.
Aww.
Yeah, because Game of Thrones. Like, I think everybody was naming their kids either Arya or Daenerys at that point.
Okay.
And one of them, like half of them turned out to be good. Half of them turned out to be disappointed. So that's what happens. Like some of them named their kids Khaleesi straight up. Just like nothing else.
In real. For
For real, yeah. And then in the show, she goes crazy.
I don't know.
It's okay.
Have you watched Game of Thrones? Yeah, me neither. No. Yeah, so
I think y'all are more inclined to become like each other's besties. I think this is like a I'm introducing y'all to each other types, and then you'll take over
later.
Is that why you ask the question that you feel jealous if your fag hag is sharing?
Maybe, it's
a conspiracy against me now at this point.
I've never felt so wanted. Swayamvar.
But also, like, there's a disparaging, like the fact that you're from like a very different lifestyle also. Like, you're from Colaba, you grew up in South Bombay, art gallery, all of that. And then here I am, like a humble, stupid boy from Bandra who's not seen much of luxury in life. So I don't know, I don't even sometimes like try to decipher how we became friends. I just use that as a joke sometimes that if we both can be best friends and world peace is possible, like, shut the UN down. Because, like, nobody knows people from South Bombay and suburbs being besties.
Bhayandar, like, that's two proper poles.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but I'm not typical South Bombay, right?
Not typical, but there's like a element of that in you.
Yeah.
Especially when you're driving cars. She turns into a angry English auntie for some
reason. Can you drive?
I can't.
Wow.
That's why I need her.
We should do an entirely different episode about gays who can't drive.
Oh, we should have, like, I think the whole room will be filled.
I know, right?
But there's a lot of men in this day and age that don't drive.
Yeah, but it's a running joke now. I see it a lot online, like memes and stuff about how gay guys just don't know how to drive. And they don't even like have any inclination. I don't even have a driver's license.
Yeah.
As in, I ride a bike every year, my Activa. But
Activa is not a bike, no?
Nice. In fact, we call it Ida Pav Bike in Parsi, which means like it's just a bike to get bread and eggs. So, yeah.
That's actually true.
But I dated a proper biker type dude also, like who had like 7 bikes of different kinds.
Oh, yeah, from Bangalore.
From Bangalore. Like,
oh, my God.
What happened to you?
That relationship was not a nice one.
It was 3 months of just like... And Jeeya seen me like through most of this where I'm just like, I have nowhere to vent.
Wait, so
like,
if you all know each other for 3 years and 9 months was Dubai boy, 3 months... Okay, but you're doing like short bursts. You're doing short bursts.
Right? Yeah.
He also has these one night stands, right?
So okay.
Yeah. And I update her about everything. And then she tells me nothing.
What's the worst thing he's ever told you that you wish you hadn't heard? Is there anything that comes to mind, like off the top of your head?
I think there are many things.
Like, which made you question, like, oh, I can't believe I'm friends with this fag.
No, no, nothing like that. Not okay. Really bad. But like this one time he had a problem in his ass. What was it called? And his mom was like, oh shit, you're out of commission now.
Because you have no idea where all my brain is. What is this problem?
I just had a fissure, the anal
fissure.
Oh no. Yeah, the cute one. Shit. Cute tissue tear.
Oh, yeah, there's no cute fissure ever. Ever
seen mine.
Except
in 6 feet
under. But like what?
That's the only like, you know, weird thing that I've ever known of Navin
I was in Goa and I ate too many like fish and like prawns and crustaceans, which usually goes to heat. And then like, so I had to buy one of those hemorrhoid creams where it's like
I had hemorrhoids for like, not hemorrhoids, but I had fissures and fistulas.
Yeah, yeah,
that's for like true. 2 years when I was a teenager.
You face so much tragedy in your morning routine every day.
Fuck, it was the worst.
But like, so I was just like walking around like a penguin everywhere around the house also. And my mom's like, Naoto, you're out of commission. No?
Just like, that was best. I was like, that is epic.
Mom did an anal joke without doing an anal joke. Like, that's how it was.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so it was. And then like when Jeeya and my mom met, they vibed really well. My mom was like, yeah, Jeeya's pretty bindas. Like she doesn't care about what anybody thinks. She came to my house, packed pork and took it in a dabba. She like, I don't care. I'm just like, auntie, pack it for me. I'll pack this, I'll pack that. Take chutney, idli and all of that. And then she just like,
oh, the idli was so good. I've never had better idli in my life.
Yeah?
The one that Naveen's mom makes.
That's why even after I left home and everything, I still go back home once in a while. Just because
for the
food in general. Like all of that my mom cooks, there's an element of love in it. I don't know how long that'll continue. So like,
it'll be forever.
Like until she's alive.
He's a proper mama's boy.
Is he?
Yeah, yeah. Full
I'm
on.
Learning a lot of things about you today.
Yeah.
Mama's boy, fishers.
I think the fisher, the whole world would know if they saw me around that time. Because I was just like, I was one of those.
Yeah, even I used to waddle.
Like, you know how those. What do those Teletubbies work?
Yeah.
That's how I was walking.
I know that feeling.
I went to a friend's wedding like that, dude. Like, I was dancing.
In Goa. Yeah, yes.
Yeah. I was trying to do the Egyptian step only because that's the only way I could walk.
Oh my God. You know who cured my fissures? Sorry to go away from the. Baba Ramdev.
What?
Yeah.
How?
I once. So I was
bogged in. That's damn funny.
Here's the deal. And which is so weird because everybody hates him and rightfully because of what he said about gay people and stuff.
But he also was legalized marijuana.
But he literally saved my whole fissure thing. I remember it was a problem I had for a year or two when I was a teenager. And I tried everything. I tried the Isab girl. I tried the creams up my butt. I tried every fucking thing. Nothing would work. I remember one day late in the night, Astha channel, I used to, for fuck's sake, I used to just like watch it. And he said, when you wake up in the morning, okay, and whoever's listening and has fissures, just try this, okay? Because it worked in 3 days. Basically, he said every morning when you wake up, you take a glass of chilled milk, you put a drop of lemon in it, and before the milk curdles, you just gulp it down. I did it for a week. I never had fissures after that. I'm not even kidding.
Oh, that's good cure.
I'm not even
like
kidding.
You're shitting rubbly now.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Baba.
Yeah, even I have a Baba Ramdev joke. And all. Cool, awesome. So we are obviously back with this new season. Our new episodes are out. And you can check out more videos on my YouTube, which is Navin Noronha. We have snippets from the podcast going out. So you can see what we look like while we do this shit. And Jeeya is obviously on Instagram as Jeeya Dadak Dadak, which is JeeyaDhadak. DHADK. And we have Farhad as curator.
You can find me on Instagram and Twitter. I changed it for this purpose. You can just look up Farhad Karkaria and
the new and improved Farhad Karkaria with his new handles
on Instagram and Twitter.
All right. And I am House of Noronha on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. You can find me. And if you like this show, you can check out more IVM podcast shows on the IVM podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from. We'll see you next week. Bye.
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 सॉरी गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर फक्त तुमच्यासाठी दर बुधवारी IVM पॉडकास्टच्या ऍपवर, वेबसाईटवर किंवा युट्यूब चॅनलवर सुद्धा ऐकू शकता. तुम्ही आमचा पॉडकास्ट वेगवेगळ्या पॉडकास्ट प्लॅटफॉर्मवरती ऐकू शकता. फक्त सर्च करा गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर आणि आमचा पॉडकास्ट ऐकत रहा.
Hey Meghna, do you know how to citizen?
Hey Shreyas, do you know how to citizen?
Hey Meghna, do you know how to citizen?
Hey Shreyas, let's just do a podcast about it.
Let's do a podcast about it. A podcast is called How to Citizen. In every episode, we get a new guest and discuss one chapter from the 8th grade civics textbook. Think about it as three friends revising before a test. And we go back to school. There's nostalgia, there's trauma, there are lunch breaks, there are favorite teachers, there are horrible teachers, there's everything.
So every Tuesday we bring in a guest on the podcast and we ask them a very simple question. Do you know how to citizen?
Meghna, I think the question is, do you know how to citizen?
But Shreyas, I'm asking you this question.